I've never met anybody odder. Never had a credit card, never had a checking account, never, you know, he didn't know how to do anything except buy cash. And he didn't have any social graces because he'd never learned any.
He was shy. He was a loner. He seemed much more withdrawn, much more alone than he did before, kind of a pathological level.
His parents weren't wealthy, and they weren't even middle class. It was a poor home, and his parents didn't want to have anything to do with golf.
I think he wanted to be the best at something, and I think hitting a golf ball was it.
Golf was a refuge for him. Through golf, he just found this place of serenity and peace.
Imagine you're a kid back in Kitchener, and you're setting pins in a bowling alley, and you've just won the Canadian Amateur. And one night he comes home, and there's this invitation to the Masters. The night before the first round, Snead offers him some advice.
That was sad. That was Sam Snead giving me golf lessons. And I stayed out there all night hitting balls.
It's 800 golf balls that night. His hands get raw, so he's got to tee it up the next day in the Masters with basically raw hands.
The gloves filled with blood, and he couldn't grip the club.
And after 9 or 10 holes, his hands were just too raw for him to continue.
Good thinking, good golf. Bad thinking, bad golf. That simple.
And the best record of all the world's ever known. Not by my say. I don't believe I am. All the best players and best DJs will say, who's the best record of the ball ever?
Wherever he went to a tournament, whether it was Faldo, Crenshaw, couples, they certainly would stop and watch him hit balls.
Because Mo never curved it, right? It was always dead straight with every golf club.
Never offline. This swing can't hit a crooked.
Fred Couples was watching him on the Tuesday of the Canadian Open. Couples had played 18 holes in practice already, had no intention of going out and playing again. Then he watched Mo. He just looked at his caddy and he says, Joe, he says, I'm so jacked up after seeing this guy hit golf balls. Let's go play another 9 holes.
They were talking about Mo as being a kind of a savant of the game, somebody who just instinctively knew how to hit a golf shot, how to shape a golf ball.
Sometimes you have that feeling when you're about to see something that everybody's talked about, and people talked about the way Mo Norman hit the golf ball.
Wherever I wanted to go, every time.
You'd think it can't be that good. He can't be that good.
It's hard to describe how good it really was. I'd seen a lot of great ball strikers. The best guys in the world I've played golf with.
The purity of technique is choking me. Oh yes, I always see it, but I taste it too. I could taste that before I hit it. Look.
You should watch him hit a golf ball. It's freakish how good he is.
His golf swing, he thoroughly owned it. I believe it is the most efficient, simple way to hit a golf ball ever devised.
You use the same tee the whole time, don't you?
It's 7 years old. Never moves.
Our story about Mo Norman is not a story of golf. It's a story of a man. It's a character drama. It's an underdog story. It's about somebody who should have never succeeded, but did.
I did it my way, and I'm not ashamed one bit.